all the groups do different deals that suit them. And what the guys in one of my first groups did, they actually did an auction deal first. So they went to auction, they bought for cash, they did up, and they refinanced back out. So I think they bought in auction for about 40,000. So again, we're in Wales, for anyone watching this who's in London or, you know, southeast, the figures sound ridiculous, but it does happen. You know, we're doing it now. It's not something that happened 10 years ago. So they bought for about, I think they bought for about 40. Must have spent 8, something like that. If any of them are watching it and want to comment, then they can. It valued up, I think, at 75. So they ended up pulling most of the money back out. It's now rented to a tenant for about 400 a month. And it's cash flowing, and they need to manage it. So
positive cash flow straight away.
Yeah, straight away. So they had a couple of months of, you know, doing the refurb. They learned a huge amount. And again, I can't teach in a video or in a classroom what people go through when they learn to do the refurbs. You know, this is not a peachy ride where it's just like, oh yeah, we just did a refurb. It was just, you know, it was just easy. They had fallouts in the sense of personality clashes. Things didn't get done when people said they were going to do. So they all grew a huge amount as well as doing the property. And they, yeah, it's rented out now, and they'll probably keep that forever. And effectively, I can't remember what they've got, maybe 5,000 tops left in it. So for a £5,000 investment, when it all came out in the wash, they've got £200 a month. Show me a bank where you can get that, you know, or a share dividend or whatever. It just doesn't happen. The flip side is they get it wrong and it's completely devastating the other way. So, it, you know, I think that's where people who are interested in property, they get really kind of wide-eyed about the figures that work, but they don't realise the risk and the downside. So what those guys had to put in to get that reward was massive. They're all working full-time running their own businesses, and then they did this on top. You know, they were there at weekends or on a Friday night or, you know, on a call. I think they have their call on a weekday evening. I've got another group that have a call at 6 a.m. on a Friday morning because it's the only time when all of them can get together.